Have you ever text someone a website and it looks like this? I'm gonna help you make it look like this. Hola, my name is Betsy. I'm from Betsy Lugo Creative, where I help new and small entrepreneurs launch their e-commerce website. I am here to give you all of the knowledge that I've gained over the last few years so that you can design, maintain, and elevate your Shopify store. So let's get started. Okay, my friends, so we're here in the Shopify dashboard. So the first place we're gonna go is to the brand. So we're gonna go into your settings here in the bottom left, brand. And here is where you're going to enter all of your brand information. Fun stuff. All right, so let's go one by one. So the first one is your logo. And here they give you suggestions. So if you're not sure what the correct sizes are, so here are the sizes that you need. It's telling you right here all of the different formats that Shopify accepts and then the minimum size that is required. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and upload a logo. So some of this is already uploaded in here in my file. So I'm just gonna bring it over. So that is going to be my logo there. Then the second one is going to be another version of your logo, and it's going to be a small version of your logo. So sometimes, depending on where it's going to be shared, it might show up as a circle, and Shopify will automatically go ahead and make that adjustment. So let's go ahead and add the square logo. So for my shop here, I have the little coffee cup. And here's an example. As we fill this out, this will go ahead and start to auto-generate. And so this is the little circle that I just mentioned. So it might be a square or it might be a circle. So just create it as a square, a minimum of 112 by 112. Again, just follow the instructions that are right here. And this is the very minimum size that the file should be. All right. You can see what it would look like a square. This is doesn't always kind of work. But so now we're going to come down to the colors. And this is going to be your primary colors for your brand. So my primary color is the green. So I'm going to go ahead and insert that there. Now we move on to the contrasting color. So if you have a contrasting color, you can enter it there. I'm going to just leave it white. It automatically added it. Fine with me. My secondary color, however, let's go ahead and bring that in. All right. And that is my secondary color. And then I have a second secondary color that I'm going to add. And here's my secondary color that I'm going to add. Okay. And so those are my colors there. And if we come up to the top, you'll see how those colors are going to be used when your brand is shared on whether it's Pinterest or it's someone texts it or, you know, anything like that. And whenever they show it, this is how it's going to show. Okay. Now the next one is going to be your cover image. So this, as it says, the key image that shows off your brand in the profile pages. Again, pay attention to the size that it's recommending for you to have at the very minimum. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and add ours here. I uploaded it in here somewhere. Where is it? Here it is. Okay. So that is that. And come back up here. That's what it would look like. Pretty cool, huh? Then the next is the slogan. So this is your brand statement or your tagline. Here, I'm gonna go ahead and enter our slogan and just, again, be mindful right here. Shopify is very good at giving you instructions. So as you see there, it's 80 characters at the most. Now, also for your slogan, in case you're struggling and you don't have one, Shopify has a resource for you. So if you head on over to shopify.com tools slogan maker, and I'll add the link to the description below, you can create a slogan. So here I entered healthy coffee to come up with my slogan, and it'll give you suggestions. Look, it gave me 1,023 slogans. Now I didn't use any of them, but I just wanted to show you just in case you don't have a slogan and you struggle with copy, as many people do, there is resources available that are for free that can help you do that. All right. And then moving on to our short description. So again, here, description of your business often used in bios and listings. And this is what up to 150. So I'm going to go ahead and enter ours here. All right, awesome. Then the last one is your social links. So here you will enter all of your social media links. You could just go ahead and enter them all in here. And if you want any more further instructions, as always, Shopify gives a lot of support, so you can always click on manage your brand settings, okay? So once you completed everything, as you can see, everything here is checked off, and this is how it would look on all of the different platforms. So pretty cool, huh? All right, now don't forget to save. All right, great. So now all of the branding is set up for you. Now we're going to go to part two, which is in preferences. All right. So here is, you're going to fill out your title and meta description here, which is similar to what we already did. And then the social sharing image, which is the same as the logo that I did before. Okay. For the homepage, I just used the name of the shop. So we'll do that. And the meta description again is the same. We're going to use the same one that we did previously. And the meta description is the part when you know, when you Google, you have the name of a title and then you have a short description of something. This is what this is. So we're going to go ahead and use that same one that we used in the branding and insert it in here. Again, just be mindful that this section holds up to 320. So it holds a little bit more characters than the 150 from the previous page. Right. And then your social sharing image, which you will enter here. And again, here it shows you this is where it's going to be used. So as you saw in the intro, and I'll show it again here, this is this image here. Okay, so you enter that there and click save. Beautiful. So now we're going to go to part three, which is right inside of the theme settings. Okay, beautiful. So we're inside of the customization of the shop. So we're going to come here where it says theme settings, and we're going to finish off our branding. So we're going to do with our colors. What happens here is that this will pull from the brand that we just entered. If it doesn't, you can simply just enter the information here, enter your hex code here, or you can simply click right here where it says dynamic source, and it's going to give you a list of all the colors that you imported in the brand. So for instance, if this was the original Shopify colors, then you would just come here and enter the color that is yours. Okay, and you're going to do that for all of these if it doesn't already. So what this means is now that you can add all of the information in the brand setting, and your theme setting will pull all this information in. All of my colors are set, which are beautiful. I don't have to change anything, but if you do, please go ahead and do so. Then your font is the next part of your settings. You have options. You can use the ones that are already in Shopify because they provide you with tons and tons of fonts here. So you are welcome to use any of these fonts, but you also have the option of uploading your own custom fonts. So you do have that option. So know that. Okay. So you're going to have two different fonts. So you're going to set your headings font, and you're going to set your body font. So your heading is all of these that are here, like this one here and this one here. And then all of your body fonts is this part here, this part down here. Okay. All right. Moving on, favicon. So in your favicon here, you're going to go ahead and select your favicon because we didn't do it in the brand settings. So here we're going to upload our favicon here. All right, beautiful. You should make your favicons 50 by 50 pixels. However, Shopify is going to reduce it to 32 by 32 pixels, which is what it's telling you here. Okay. And now if you're wondering what in the world is a favicon, so let me go ahead and save this and show you what that is. The favicons are these little guys up here that tell you what website you're on for each of these pages. All right, so that's the favicon there. And we saved. Yes, we did. Okay, just in case your theme is one of the themes that does not bring in the information from the brand setting, the other location where you can enter your logo so it shows up here in your header is right here. Right, so you click on header and your logo image, you can upload it right here. So just to recap, these are the items that you're going to need to set up your branding. You need two versions of your logo, your hex colors, your cover image, slogan, description, and all of your social media links. That's it, my friends. That's how you set up your branding in Shopify so that you show up consistently everywhere. All right. All of the links for all of the resources I shared today are in the description below. Till next time. Adios. Have you ever texted anyone and today we're going to talk about all things. Hello. Today we're going to talk about all things branding.